everybody. I'm Larry Ridley. This is Madden 18 on EA Sports. Anticipation is mounting for today's game. We've got two quarterbacks looking to make an impact. It's Roethlisberger Steelers going up against Manning's Giants.
Thank you, Larry. Coming to you from just off the New Jersey Turnpike in East Rutherford, we are just about set for football on EA Sports from MetLife Stadium. This crowd a few minutes ago stirred into action at the sight of their men in blue emerging from the MetLife tunnels. We're set to go as the Giants get ready to match up with the Pittsburgh Steelers. Down. And his first pass is incomplete. He was looking for Odell Beckham that time. And now it's second down.
Let's face it, perfection is something we all chase, whether it's playing this game or whatever we do. Hard to attain, but that's what they were searching for as that pass goes incomplete.
So second and 10 here. To throw again. Manning. Pressure comes and the Steelers take him down. Stephon Tuitt in there to bring him down for a loss of 7. He didn't get rid of the football there, took the sack. Although that's easier said than done. He can't just chuck the thing sideways into the seats.
No, he really can't because
they've got his man complete. It's a big play for the Giants on third down. 41 yards.
I'm sorry, but it's almost unfair. I mean, Brandon Marshall can make so many plays, but even when you think he's covered.
He's not.
No, he's really not. He uncovers and makes a play on you and picks up good yardage in doing so.
That throw good for 4. It's second down.
I know exactly what's going to be said about that play from the defensive perspective.
What's that?
That's why I tell all you guys we need more than one tackler to the ball. He broke the first tackle. Luckily enough, there were more people there to get him down.
Here's Manning to throw. And he's able to get it back to right around the 27. Certainly not how they envisioned ending their opening drive here in the first quarter.
Too many ones in this play. First quarter, first drive. First interception thrown.
And that last one, that hurts.
Here we go.
This is Bell. And he will lose yardage here back at the 23-yard line. That's going to go as a loss of 4, and it'll be second down.
Came out in a power set, but that only served to put more men in the box. And guess what? If you're going to do that, you've got to win up front, right? Your offensive guys have got to beat the defenders. They lost all leverage on that play.
Dobbs is throwing. And on the left sideline, he caught it, but out of bounds, according to the head linesman. Incomplete, so the ball a little late getting there, and it's third down.
Well, there's times when you see these catches that are made, and we just know the guys playing it are really wishing for college rules. Only need that one foot down instead of 2. It's awfully difficult on the sideline, isn't it?
Incomplete pass on second down. Let's see what the offense draws up here on third. Out of the gun, Dobbs. He rifles one that's intercepted. Picked off by Dominique Rodgers-Cromartie. And he will bring it back. It's a pick 6 and a Giants touchdown. He was second in the NFL last year with 6 interceptions. This time, not only the interception, but also 6 points.
And it's just so difficult to go get the football in this league because people are so proficient in the passing game. It's not easy at all to read patterns, to break on the football, catch the ball, take it the other way. Yeah, when you have a guy like that on your team, you feel really good about his efforts.
And that'll carry over the back line of the end zone for a touchback. Out comes the Steeler offense now, ready to see what they can do here. They'll start out on the ground with Bell. And he's brought down, getting this one up to about the 35. It'll be a gain of 10 to start the drive out by a few inches. That'll be a first down.
Tremendous blocking by the interior of the offensive line. They didn't just gash him there. They blasted a gaping hole for him to gallop through. I think if he comes back to the huddle, he better be giving them a whole lot of credit and thanking them for that much space to rumble.
And they'll keep it on the ground with Bell. 2 yards on the carry there. It'll be second down. We haven't seen much from him running the football here in this first quarter.
No, you're right about that. We haven't seen much of him at all so far. They've stacked him up pretty well. But when you're trying to run the football, sometimes you've got to play the long game. Keep handing it to him. And some of those runs that aren't working now, they turn into 6, 7, 8, and maybe more later on. I think there's one element that just keeps increasing on defense in the NFL, and that's speed. They wanted it every position, and we just saw there some linebackers didn't go sideline to sideline, run past that trash, go past people, and make tackles near the sidelines.
And not only near the sideline, but also in the backfield there for the loss. From the shotgun, here's Dobbs. Goes underneath for Bell. And he'll get it out near the 40 to the 39. It'll be a 3-yard gain, and it'll be fourth down.
Everyone's got to be able to catch the football. Doesn't matter what position you play, but if you're on offense, be aware a ball may come your way.
So they're going to come to the line here, and it appears trying to go for it on fourth. They'll try and throw for it here. And he can't find anywhere to go with it, and he goes down. Boy, a curious decision to go for it doesn't pan out, and that will force a turnover on downs. Here's the Giant offense now as they get ready to take over here. And there are parts of their last drive they'd like to emulate. Of course, they'd like to forget the inning, the interception. But they did put together, Charles, a nice sustained drive to get him down the field.
Yeah, and unfortunately for them, the only thing that matters is part two, right? Because once they're through the interception and finish off the drive, that does them no good to go back and say, well, you know, we had a good one going. Finish things off. That's the only way you can get it done.
Tough running there. That's a hard-earned 4 yards.
Yeah, those are the unsung kind of runs. They don't fill up the stat sheet, but they do set you up in good position on second down.
Possible run anticipation here as the D-line sandwiches together. They'll run again here with Gallman. And this time he's not going anywhere. They'll get him down right at the line of scrimmage. They'll say no gain on the play there. Now it'll be third down. And when you're running the football, one thing you don't want to see is a big boy coming up there to swallow you whole in those D tackles and nose tackles.
No, you're actually counting on your big boys to protect you from them. But on that play, the defensive tackle had the leverage, and he won the battle. No gain, correct?
No gain. They had great starting position to begin the drive, but now they look up at a 3rd and 5. From the gun, it's Manning. And incomplete. The contact made the ball roam free and brings up 4th down. Charles, that's an important 3rd down stop. You don't want to spot him 2 touchdowns here early.
You're trying to slow momentum down. You've already given up the score. They're coming right back at you. You're exactly right. Being able to hold them there and force a decision on 4th down, that's big for the defense.
And the kick by Rosas is good. And the lead moves to 10-0. So a good kick there, and they finish off the drive with 3.
And that should be the goal for an offense. Finish each drive with points. So that's a nice job there to come away with at least something.
And they will not get a chance to return this one as it's through the end zone for a touchback. And the Steelers set to take the field. And on that last drive, went for it on 4th, turned it over. But good job by their defense, though. They held them to 3, but this offense, they've got to be a little bit better, a little bit more careful here.
And sometimes when you see these calls on 4th down, when they decide to go for it, it's not necessarily the coach saying, I believe in my offense. Sometimes the coach saying, I believe in my defense. I can afford to go for it here, because if we don't get it, I don't think we'll give up more than 3. And that's exactly what happened there.
You think that factored in?
I do. I think that he had that in his mind going into the game, that I'm going to be aggressive on offense because I know I've got a defense that can hold up their end.
And a big hit there as he runs into a brick wall right at the line of scrimmage. They'll say no gain on the play there, and now it'll be third down. Back with Charles Davis, Brandon Gaudin. It's Steeler football to begin quarter number two. They've got a third down and five to start things out. Throw now for the backup, Roethlisberger. And he couldn't hang on to it through the contact. Incomplete.
I'm not sure we could spot any tendency here on this third down. They could have run it or passed it. Either one was available. They chose to try and get it through the air, but they were unsuccessful.
Roethlisberger will stay out there, and they're going to go for it on fourth. They'll indeed go for it with Roethlisberger. Hits his target, Hunter. And he's got the first down yardage as he brings this up to the 47. It'll be a gain of 17 at a Pittsburgh first. Now Roethlisberger on first down. And no escaping this time as he'll go down. They got him for a sack. second down, here's Roethlisberger. A dump off to Toussaint. And he'll get it out near the 40 to the 39. 6 yards on the pickup, and they're going to be staring at a third and long here.
I know most of the time when the ball's in the air, you're thinking wide receiver, tight end, but running backs, they can be a big part of any passing offense nowadays.
The Steelers on third down, 0 for 3 to this point. They could use a conversion. This will be a tough third and 18. Out of the gun, it's Roethlisberger. Buying time to his left. Now he's going to let into heavy traffic, and it's intercepted. Picked off by Eli Apple. And I think he's going to go. They're not going to get him. And he will bring it back. It's a pick six and a Giants touchdown. And he also had an interception return for a touchdown last year. Another one there. What's the goal for a defensive back? One a season?
One a season is really
fantastic.
Way more than you would expect. I mean, guys set those types of goals, but rarely are they reached. Rarely they achieve. To be able to pull it off back-to-back seasons, who says no one makes house calls anymore?
So they throw the pick six. They'll get another shot at it now as this one's in the air. On the return, Fitzgerald, Toussaint. Able to push his way through. And he'll get across the 20 before he's brought down at about the 23-yard line. And now out come the Steelers. The slot man in motion right. They'll start the drive with a carry by Bell. Call it a gain of 4 on first, and that'll make it second down.
When you find that kind of yardage, you couldn't be more confident as a ball carrier. And guess what? You're going to go back and tell your offensive coordinator, I'd like to keep carrying it, thank you.
On second down, it's Bell. And he'll get about 3 here as he's out to the 30.
Well, he hasn't made much of an impact in the running game thus far. And after that last run, not much is going to change in that area.
He hasn't been able to get anything going. And really, the offensive line not helping him much. The Steelers on third down. Not good. 0 for 4 thus far. Here it's 3rd and 3. They'll try and run for it with Bell. And tough going there as he'll only get it up to about the 31. Just a 1-yard gain on the play, and that'll mean a call to the punt team as it's 4th down.
But forget knowing where the first down line was. This defense created their own line of scrimmage. They won every battle up front, and a lot of times that is one-on-one. And if you win your one-on-ones enough times, your defense is going to be pretty good. They had more people to the football and snuffed out the play.
They'll go for it with Bell. And he's got the first down yardage before he's brought down at the 42. A Steeler first down on the pickup of 11 yards. Two minutes to play here in the first half. We're back to East Rutherford, but first this timeout. So the D-line's going to spread out. Throwing now, Roethlisberger on first down. And this is caught by Martavis Bryant. And he'll get it into enemy territory just across midfield at the 49.
Well, coaches always talk about finding balance on offense. I don't think you can get much more balance than this. Big-time run, big-time pass.
A 1-2 combination. Looked pretty good.
How about that? Let's see if they can continue to take that kind of a punch, though.
Now Roethlisberger going to hand to Bell, and he'll be brought down at the 45-yard line. A gain of 4 that time as the drive continues.
Second and inches is oftentimes an invitation for an offense coordinator to take a big shot downfield because he feels like he can come back on third down and pick up the first down. But sometimes you just don't want to break tendency. Stay with what you are, stay with who you know, and go get the first down. That's exactly what they do.
Now a play fake here on first down. And a big loss here as he's taken down.
I'm starting to feel for that quarterback back there. I mean, you know me. Normally, don't have a lot of empathy for the QB, right? In this case, definitely. He's been under constant duress this entire game. I don't know how he's surviving back there.
And to think, there's still a long way to go in this football game. Second down, Roethlisberger, and he connects with Vance McDonald, and he'll be brought down, it looks like, right at the 40. And before they can run this third down play, we're going to get a timeout as the clock stops here with 46 seconds remaining in the first half. And the Steelers on third down, a pretty woeful 0 for 5 thus far. This will be third and 5. Slot man moves right. First carry for James Conner. No gain on the play there, and it'll bring up fourth down. Nice job there defensively to clamp down because, really, they've been on their heels this drive.
Agreed, and they really needed that one for confidence, just to feel a little bit better. But I don't know if I would be daunted by them stopping me on one run. This drive has gone pretty well. I could come right back at them.
Fourth down. Here's Roethlisberger. Oh, and this ball's tipped and intercepted. Picked off by Dominique Rodgers-Cromartie. And his guys have got it back at the closing stages of the first half. And now out come the Giants. And the ball backed way up. So thinking with this amount of time on the clock, probably just sit on it, and we'll see these two teams go to the lockers.
Yeah, I don't think you want to overthink it in this situation. Either side of the ball. Just go ahead and finish up the half and get on out and talk about it.
To throw, it's Manning. He's going to leave this for his running back. It's complete. Brought down around the 16 or 17. Had a nice move, but couldn't free much space. Just a one-yard pickup on the play, and it'll be second down. So we have reached halftime in our first preseason matchup of the year. Boy, rough crowd. No football for 6 months. Already we're skipping halftime. All right, let's get right back to the action. We're set for quarter three. And this will be a touchback as that sails over the end line. The Steeler offense now with a football first here to begin the third quarter. They come out here with a zero on the scoreboard. What was said in that locker room? That's what I want to know.
I would love to have been in there because we often have the feeling that there's a lot of shouting, screaming, people upset. But typically, halftime locker rooms are a lot more clinical than that. And in this case, are they upset that the plays weren't working because of execution? Or did they think just they were just bad plays to call?
Yeah.
We'll find out pretty quickly here if they feel like they had something going, but they just need to do it a little bit better or not.
We'll find out.
Offense still needing 10 yards. Second down. Roethlisberger with a give to Bell. And not a whole lot doing there as he'll get it up to about the 28-yard line. It's a gain of about 3, but it's going to leave him with third and still 7 yards to go. Here's Roethlisberger sliding out of the pocket. And incomplete here on third down. Well, this. Secondary's done such a good job of frustrating these receivers tonight. Another example right there on the deep ball.
Sometimes when the sun goes down and it's just the bright lights in the stadium, puts a little extra spring in their step, doesn't it? And that's what we're seeing from the defenders. Doesn't matter whether it's man or zone. Deep ball, short ball, and that was a deep one there. They're making plays on the football, contesting everything.
Here we go.
go on fourth down with Roethlisberger. He's going to wind up and air it out. And this is going to be incomplete. So certainly an interesting call there to go for it. And the Giants are going to take over in great field position. Now we take a glance at the offense as they work their way back out for their first possession of the second half. This is sort of what you would call a put-away drive, isn't it? They score here, especially a touchdown. It's almost out of reach.
It certainly feels that way, and I think that they're going to call their plays accordingly, because what you really want to do, even though you know the scoreboard is still up there and the game's going to go on, you feel like you can take the spirit away from another team, that their drive and will to come back and win can be taken with another score right here.
Still third quarter, but you just get that feel.
Yeah, they're teetering right there on the brink, aren't they?
And he's going to fight his way forward here for a modest gain. He'll get a nice chunk there on the first down run, and it's second and four.
Third quarter, and you've got the lead. You're not ready to go into that four-minute offense to close the game out, but a running game can really benefit your team right now.
Zebra, zebra, zebra. Shift together here from the D-line. On second down, Perkins. Open space inside the 10. And he will take it on in for a Giant touchdown. Paul Perkins, 22 yards. And the Giants are able to grow their lead.
Well, partner, that was another explosive run. And one thing I've learned in our time in this game, yes, the offensive line has to get a lot of credit, but for big runs to occur, the wide receivers have to block well downfield.
And then you have to have a good guy carrying the ball too, right?
Oh, without a doubt. You need that difference maker lugging the rock.
And this will not be returnable. It's out of the back of the end zone for a touchback. The Steelers' offense now, they get ready to head back on the field. And last time out, went for it on fourth down, turned it over, gave them great field position, turned into 6 points, so they've got to recover here, Charles.
It's amazing what one decision can do in the chain of events, right? The decision to go for it on fourth down
caused all of that.
It caused every bit of it, but it showed confidence. Hey, I've got confidence in you guys. Go pick it up for them. Didn't happen. Also shows confidence in the defense. They didn't pick up their end of the bargain. So now they've got to come back out and start over and rebuild that confidence.
It's complete to Brown, right side. Give him 9 there on the first down completion. I think their fans are saying, hey, where's that Roethlisberger to Brown connection been in this one?
First time they get together is in the second half. I don't think any of us would have predicted that going in, because we know how valuable that is to their offense, and that could be a big reason why they're not winning right now.
The slot man in motion right. Now Roethlisberger forced out to his left. And no escaping this time as he'll go down. They got him for a sack.
The amount of sacks that they've absorbed in this game is absolutely extraordinary. Let's just face it. This offensive line, flat out, cannot handle this pass rush. It's been demonstrated time and time again.
And the Steelers on third down, as bad as you can be. 0 for 7 thus far. This time it's 3rd and 3. From the gun, it's Roethlisberger. This is Bell on the dump off. And he's going to have the first down yardage to the 35. 3 yards there, good enough to keep the drive moving. So the offense has it 1st and 10. Slot man moves right. Now a 1st down carry by Bell. And unable to get downhill there as he'll take this up to about the 37. Give him a couple on the carry there, 2nd and 8.
Well, you know that old expression, it's not my night. It hasn't been his so far. I don't know if the legs are a little bit heavy. Sometimes having to hang out all day and play doesn't exactly play to your advantage, but it's been a tough go for him.
And every time he looks up, somebody's there defensively. That was the same case on that play.
Left, left, left!
Here we go. They'll go again with Bell. Trying to bounce it outside, but he's only able to get it back to the line of scrimmage. Officially, no gain on the play, and they're left with a 3rd and 8. And the Steelers on 3rd down. Just 1 conversion in 8 tries. Not good. This is 3rd and 8. Here's Roethlisberger. And he finds McDonald. And he will have the first down as he gets this to the 47. Pittsburgh getting 16 yards there and also a first down. The defensive line disperses a little bit here, maybe expecting a pass. Roethlisberger will hand to Connor. And that play will go nowhere, losing yardage back near midfield at the 49. A loss of a full 3 yards, and now it's second down. Second down and a little ways to go here. Second and 13.
Go back, go back. Left, left. Where'd he go? He's 30. He's two.
From the shotgun, it's Roethlisberger. Dancing to his left. And he's got Rome. It's a gain of 9 yards. And that's going to lead to a third down.
Okay, he's not going to get the first down, but this is still a nice job of buying some time and then running to get to the sideline and get out of bounds and avoid the big hit.
And on third and 5, this will be the 8th play of the drive. Here's Roethlisberger to throw. He completes it to Bryant. And into the end zone. Touchdown, Pittsburgh. Martavis Bryant, 42 yards. And the Steelers are able to cut into that deficit. And they'll get set here looking for the 2-point conversion.
Let's go now.
Now it's Roethlisberger. And they're going to get the 2-point conversion, caught in the end zone, and that cuts the lead a bit further. Boswell on now to kick this one away. This will be fielded at the 8. Nifty move. And a good effort on the return there, gets him across the 30 to the 33-yard line. The Giants offense now, they get ready to head back on the field. And they're hoping to redo their efforts in the last drive when they got into the end zone.
And just think of what it's like now on the sideline. Because when you score a touchdown, you have to go over and look at the tablet and see what you did on the last drive. When you scored points, it's a whole lot better view than when you're trying to figure out how to fix things there.
They'll let Perkins carry to start the drive. And he'll get this only up to about the 35. Just a yard on the pickup there, and it'll bring up a 2nd and 9.
Nice job by that defensive front there to hold him to a short gain on first down. Well played, I must say.
Yeah, only getting 1 yard. There was no room to run. Welcome back now here in East Rutherford. It's the Giants with the football and also the lead as we get set to start quarter number 4. Second down, and incomplete there. A nice hit, jars the ball free, and brings up third down.
That would have been a great catch, but it's real difficult to hold on to it because it was contested all the way. Would have been a great play if he'd been able to haul that one in.
Throwing is Manning on third down. And intercepted. Maybe the turning point they need. Snags it for the pick. And the return across midfield into the 46-yard line. Well, they're not making it easy on themselves here down the stretch. 2 picks now in the 4th quarter trying to hang on to that lead.
Talk about keeping someone in the game. Instead of being able to shut the door, it's still cracked open because they can come back on you now. The only people who are really happy about those picks, any fantasy team that has this defense.
And some changes here as the D-line separates some. They go play action here on first down. And he couldn't hang on. Would have been their fourth pick of the game. Instead, second down. I guess they're in a situation now, fourth quarter, where they're forced to take some chances, but I don't know that that was the type of a chance you want to take.
And that one could very easily have been intercepted. And if it does get picked off, that could possibly seal this one.
Unable to connect on the first down pass play. Now it's second down. To throw here, Roethlisberger goes underneath for Bell. And he'll be brought down at the 45-yard line. It'll be a pickup of only a yard. And all of a sudden here, it's third down. Roethlisberger will throw. He sets to fire deep. This is caught inside the 15. And he gets this one all the way down inside the 15, just shy of the 10. An excellent pickup of 34 yards. And now a first down following that long gain. Again, it's Roethlisberger. And caught in the end zone. Touchdown, Steelers. Vance McDonald, a 12-yard touchdown grab. And the Steelers are able to close the gap just a bit. All right, now a big two-point conversion attempt still to come. To throw again is Roethlisberger. And they're going to get the two. It's caught. So they get the conversion. And now we're back to a one-score game. Boswell on now to kick this one away. And that'll carry over the back line of the end zone for a touchback. The Giants offense now gets ready to head back onto the field. And following the interception, just any interception, are you a little bit more cautious when you start that next drive, or no, you just throw that out the window?
I think you are. I don't think that there's any way you can run back out there and go, totally didn't affect me. I'll just go ahead and be loose with the football again. You're going to take care of it, but you have to be careful about being too cautious, because now you can't run any offense at all.
Still want to attack. We'll see how they attack them here. Perkins on first down. And taking it across midfield and inside the 45. A nice pickup there, 10 yards, and it'll move the sticks. And I'm guessing you'd say this is kind of the key here. Grind out some yardage, work on that clock, see if you can continue to tick it down.
Definitely. You want to bleed things out at this point, right? Continue to possess the football, gain some yardage, and put the onus on the defense. Do they have to use timeouts? What are they going to do to stop you? You're taking charge.
Clock running, under four to play now as they come up on first and 10. Shotgun now for Manning. And look at this. They get the turnover they needed. It's intercepted. Picked off by the linebacker, Arthur Motes. And his guys are going to take over at the 34-yard line. The Steelers offense now, they head back onto the field. And they're hoping to capture some of that magic they had last time out when they were able to put together a scoring drive. But they're still down here, Charles.
Not the major concern, though, because of what you talked about. They scored the last time out. They feel good about themselves. They feel like their game plan is now in effect. They know how to attack and what plays they want to put together. But they've got to keep it moving in the right direction, because as you did note, they are down on the scoreboard.
Got a man. It's Brown. And he'll get up near the 45. They'll spot it at the 44. 10 yards on the pickup there, and it'll be second down. Now Roethlisberger to throw on second down. Being chased out left. When in doubt, do it yourself as he keeps it for three and a first down. Late in the game, defense trying to avoid a big play. He's able to work out of the passing game, turn it into a run, pick up the first, and stop the clock as well.
And you know, in this situation, everything is sped up. The intensity, the thinking, everyone's movement. But for a quarterback, he has to continue to do what we call a flatliner. Level in everything he does and read the clock, feel it in the pocket, and go at the appropriate time.
On second down, here's Roethlisberger. And he can't get away from the pressure. The Giants get there.
My man, it's been a rough night for that offensive line, and it's only getting rougher. Five sacks now that they've given up in this contest so far. It feels like the witching hour out here, doesn't it?
Okay, stupid question. What's the witching hour?
Yeah, the witching hour. That's when everything goes haywire late at night.
So the sack, and now a third and long situation for the Steelers and Ben Roethlisberger. Out of the gun, it's Roethlisberger. And, oh, a crusher there as it's intercepted. Picked off by Landon Collins. And a great return here gets this one all the way down to the 26-yard line. Time for a break. We're back to see what happens after this. Really nice starting field position here for the offensive unit. Perkins on the give from Manning. And able to push his way forward here for a good little game. Yeah, give him 4 yards there. It'll be second and six.
Well, they did throw interceptions on their last two drives, so no surprise at all they decided to start it with a running play. I'm actually a little bit surprised, though, that they got as much out of it as they did.
Yeah, decent little gain. Puts them in a pretty good spot for second down.
6 yards to go here on second down. And the D-line pinching together must be expecting the run. Again, they go to Perkins. And he'll be taken down near the 20 at the 21. Now the Steelers put a stop to the action with a timeout defensively. It's just their first. They've got two more to use here in the final stages. The Giants on third down, just 1 for 3 thus far. This will be 3rd and 5. Manning going to give it to Perkins. And they'll get him down right about the 20. Now a second timeout called for by the defense. That'll leave them with just one remaining in this fourth quarter of play. So on fourth down, out trots the kicker in a big spot here. This to make it a 2-score game. And this is off the left, upright, and it caroms in. Not the most convincing kick you'll see, but he got it to go. And that will bump the lead up to 11. So barring something extraordinary, something crazy here in the closing stages, that field goal should just about put this one on ice.
Brandon, this will be a great win for him. The better team's going to win this game, no question about it.
This will be fielded at the 6. They'll bring it back to just about the 25, call it the 24-yard line. And Pittsburgh getting set to take the field. Trying to shake off the interception from the last drive. He'll look to throw. And this is intercepted. And that should do it. Picked off by Dominique Rodgers-Cromartie. And that gives him now 3 interceptions in the game.
Well, someone's locked into what they're trying to get done in the passing game. When was the last time we had someone get 3 in a contest?
2011, wasn't it? Kurt Coleman.
Oh, yeah, that's
then
right.
Then with the Eagles.
That's right. Then against with the Eagles, and I believe it was against Washington and Rex Grossman.
That's correct.
So they run with Perkins. Room here to run. And he's going to get this inside the 30.
They pick up 12 on the play there, and they move the chains.
Do my eyes deceive me, or is he getting stronger as this game moves along?
Burst seems just as good here in the fourth as it was way back in the first, doesn't it?
I do believe someone put a lot of time in the offseason and continues to condition during the season in order to continue to carry the ball at this rate.
So the run moves the chains, and here we go on first down. And no press coverage here. They are backing off in the secondary. On first down, back to Perkins. Heck of a move, and then brought down near the 23. Give him 5 on the carry there, and it'll be second down. Charles, why didn't they just take the knee there?
You're asking the question that I'm asking as well, because we've seen a lot of football where coaches decide maybe they get a little greedy. I don't know if they're doing it for stats or for what reason. We've seen it happen in college. And how about in the NFL? The miracle of the Meadowlands. All they had to do was take a knee and the game was over. The Giants ran it one more time. Ball popped free. Philadelphia picks it up and wins the game.
What year was that?
1978. I think it was in November.
And Charles, I think when the schedule comes out, all teams, no matter where they're predicted to finish, talk about protecting your home turf. They were able to do that here in this one.
Similar to a tennis match, right? Not letting them break your serve. That way you hold on to it. They got it done, and they feel very good about that victory.
So that's a wrap for Charles Davis. I'm Brandon Gunn, and this has been a presentation of the NFL on EA Sports. For more, check us out at easports.com. The Giants are winners as we say so long from MetLife Stadium.
You know, I'm like, yeah, nice P, you know?
What up, P?
Man.
La música de Harry Fry.
When I pull up, they notice me. Come and talk to me like Jodeci. But don't you be too close to me. Them goons you see, let it go for me. I bring them things. I call them, bring them things. Mucho. Bring them things, looking so expensive, rings and things. I bring them things.
Man, you don't want what them, bro. Oh, you, any better get low. Extort, you ain't got no friends. Oh, then we put that like a Chanel scarf, like rainbow. $1,000, this ain't your cloth. You ain't, that ain't no sauce. I can see the noodles made for poodles. I'm thinking about the LaFerrari coupe. 1.8, the option is the roof. Greens is a secret to the youth. Your goals are malnourished, peace spit the juice. Y'all be vaping, I be maiden. Yes. Y'all be aping, I'm Richard Mill Nation. No diamonds, just turn me on facing with gears and sprockets with the sapphire casing.
When stable. I pull up, they notice me. Come and talk to me like Jodeci. But don't you be too close to me. Them goons you see, let it go for me. I bring them things. I call them, bring them things. Mucho. Bring them things, looking so expensive, rings and things. I bring them things.
Here's a little story about a kid from Iraq. Had to show Carlito I was Benny Blanco.
Check it out.
Raindrop, offset. Plug, we the outlet. Child put me in the box, I'm a
socks off. All of face shorty, socks off. Mac Miller, Reggie Miller, Miller, the killer, Canary, Dax Stiller, White Villa, Villa, French Vanilla, garage like a kill himself, Lauren Hill, get up, crib Calabasas on the hill, had a morning, plate, Beatles won't be on the red carpet, Alcatraz bars, crash cars, ain't no future in front, my homies rip your mask off.
When I pull up, they notice me, come and talk to me, like Jodeci, but don't you be too close to me, them goons you see, let it go for me, I bring them things, I call them, he bring them things, mucho, I bring them things, looking so expensive, rings and things, I bring them things, I bring them things, I bring them things.
Okay, I was gone for a minute, but I'm back now. Sit the back down. Then like everybody nowadays, Hollywood. I was like that now. I'ma show you how to act now. I'ma show 'em how to act. I'ma show you. I'ma show 'em how to act. Okay, now picture little Bobby, just a younger, run around with his man's hands and his hands feeling like a man. Run, put a, put it to your brain like. Everybody know you ain't about it. Everything you talk about, I know I can live without it. Red light, stop, green light, go. Everything ain't what it seem like, I know. Hold up, what you mean? Where you been in? This is merely the beginning again. What you been living in? A box under the bridge like Anthony Kiedis, looking for something to complete us and maybe lead us. A long way from equalists, how they treat us. Body of a builder with the mind of a fetus. Turn on the television and see the vision they feed us. And I wish I could erase that face facts. Everybody people, everybody bleed. Everybody need some, everybody love. Everybody know how it go. Everybody people, everybody bleed. Everybody need some, everybody love. Everybody know I've been knocking Joe down like a witness. God is my witness, I'm witness. But on the real, I think I need another witness. If it was 1717, black daddy, white mama wouldn't change a thing. Light skin, certified as a house. Go figure, in my blood is the venom master. It's like the devil playing space with the pastor.
But he was born with the privilege.
Man, what the fuck is that? People told me as a child, as a little boy playing with his toys, I should be ashamed. And some people look ashamed when I rap, like my great-granddaddy didn't take a pickle to the back. Not accepted by the bottom, ghetto. I don't give a fuck, praise God, I can see the light. Everybody talk about race this, race that. I wish I could erase that, face facts. Everybody people, everybody bleed, everybody need some, everybody love, everybody know how it go. Everybody people, everybody bleed, everybody need some, everybody love, everybody know. Okay, I was gone for a minute, but I'm back now. Sit the back down, sit like everybody nowadays, Hollywood. Oh, it's like that now. I'ma show you how to act now. I'ma show 'em how to act. I'ma show you. I'ma show 'em how to act.
Yeah. Port of Miami. It's been a journey. Ain't nothing changed. A little stronger, a little wiser. Maybe a little more. Blame it on America. I'm pulling off the lot, I bought the cash. Whoa. Her future bright, don't give nobody bad. Be looking good inside the thighs. But I notice that she missing all the edges. Whoa. I run the game just by running with the running. Poor attitude, they got rich, calisthenics. Whoa. Walking in the courtroom, sipping on the beverage. Whoa. I know the judge, so I got a lot of leverage. Whoa. Rapping a cappella. Whoa. Kim Trezor, people with the weather. Whoa. I got it. Boy, don't make me be the devil. Whoa. He knocking on the door and know the password. Gave me his blessings while I'm hotter than the last verse.
Dear president, dear president. Dear president, dear president.
Let's go, let's go, let's go. All my little militant. Let's go, let's go, let's go. I'm innocent.
I got that in flight, time at Lee. I make money, I make money. On my third best, in them, I got, got the airport, I got bowling green dollars, I'm a dollars, busting down a hundred. In the bathtub, get some house shoes. I got money, I got war wounds. Get the cushion on that, ain't no dance moves. I was busted on the stoop, hanging with my Haitians. On the news, on front pages, ain't no relations. I was taking Ben Franks and bustin', 2 times in a row, that's a repeat. You end up in the. Cause they easy. I'm in the freezy. She got a, she love me like she need me. I got my Maybach flooded out with extra TVs. I make a pick up every single day. I judge a vulture when I flip the padded face.
Still 33 for love. I'ma ride to my dog sitting in jail. Oh, oh. He's that lighter on the grass, bend it back, roll. I'm on Keller, I'm on Gresham, I'm on Flash. Oh. I'm at Magic, I'm at Polish, let him go. Then it's right back to the when I'm low. Bars never close and we wide open. Kicking flavor with me, never, yeah, we look on. Rap the bottom, cause the bottom where we come from. Me no pray for little paper, need a lump sum. Real spiel, yeah, I would rather be, yeah. Broke, real, real, little rich, 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 rich. Born in love with her, she just wanna be a VIP. With her. Don't blame me, oh, they just shake me. Had to get it, how I got it on my phone to be. Don't blame me, I'm what the game made me. Not what the fame made me, I won't let it change me. I'm the same man.
I tell myself I never change, yeah.
On my block, yeah. On my, I won't stop, yeah. Play with me, I let it, yeah. Halo on me, Saint LeBron, yeah. Got me with the school, yeah. Get one, boo, yeah. You my little baby, boo, yeah. I love you like my favorite color.
Tryna say I'm on the enemy. Got a cold with my dogs, can't get in between. I can give them life, no more energy. Amen, amen. Spent about 60 on the time, I can't even lie. No way in, no way out, doubt, do or die. So I roll when I roll, must be. Amen, amen.
I can't ride Benz, I don't do peace. I peace, I gotta eat. Saber tooth, tiger, diamond tooth, teeth. Rockin' right now, won't you come peek? I was outside. The way that shake leave your mouth wide. You need to say grace for you say thanks.
Amen, amen. What's left in my life, don't know what's in store. I've been dealing with these blessings that I can't ignore. Putting up the numbers, we ain't keeping score. Amen, amen. Out here on the block, my side. Run it in our house for us, 12 o'clock. Yeah, the hood love me, but you gotta watch. Amen, amen.
I just three, I don't do sleep. Yeah, tryna see, movie. Yeah, we gon' fall through, coming through deep.
Amen, amen.
Yeah, packed it from the south, moved it to the west. Iced the logo on the cross, threw it on my neck. Yeah, when I rep the set, gotta stay blessed. Yeah,
amen, amen. People tryna say I'm on the enemy. Got a cold with my dogs, can't get in between. I can give them life, no more energy. Amen, amen.
Man, what it meant to me. Everybody tryna take the identity. Everybody around me turn to a friend of me. Sit back while I take on a remedy. I cannot let it get into me. This playing a toll on me meant to me.
Falling too fast to prepare for this. Tripping in the